Hello, welcome back to my channel. Today I have something special for you. With the recent Rust update limiting us to just 12 turrets for defense, I'm going to show you an awesome base design that maximizes your turret coverage and is perfect for a trio or small group. We have a simple 1x3 starter base that's easy to expand during the wipe. This base includes two early bunkers and two bunkers located higher up in the base. To compensate for lower turret coverage due to the recent update, I have also built a mini China wall and included a funnel wall in the design. Let's get started with the base tour. I built disconnectable bunker TCs with an extra battery slot on each side. If you ever have to disconnect your TCs, simply place a roof on this foundation. To reconnect it, just set up two triangle frames and remember to upgrade them. As we step into the compound, we have some peaks and dropbox loot. Up here we have the perfect angles to watch outside, and even angles to watch the breach. I've added barricades to make breaching even more challenging on this side. You'll find them on the other side as well. We also have some nice peaks into the compound for easy retakes. The compound is divided by chain links, and I've added bedrooms on both sides. These bedrooms provide outside peaks for quick respawns and defense. We got a small furnace funnel wall at the entrance to make breaching even harder. Now we enter the mini China wall. We find bedrooms on both sides, with nice retake peaks from the inside. There is some more space for dropboxes, but you could also use it for industrial stuff. On the way to the entrance, we got a little funnel wall pod to compensate the poor turret coverage. We have more bedrooms over here, and additional outside peaks to defend your compound. As we enter the base, we got one out of two early bunkers. These bunkers can be a game changer in the early stages of a wipe, since you increase the raid cost a lot by using them. Here we have the starter core. It's just a basic 1x3, but it got enough space to get the wipe going. You have two loot rooms and space for workbench and bags. The TC has 4k metal upkeep, as you can see when the base is fully metal. If you use stone as well, the metal upkeep will be even lower. On second and third layer, we have a compact open core. I could have gone for a larger open core, but turret coverage was a priority. And this one is easy to cover by only two turrets. There is enough space for your loot and even slots for batteries or lockers. Up here we got the inner peaks and bunkers. You got some strong angles to defend your China and funnel wall, literally from every side, which makes it hard to breach for raiders. Beds and lockers are also available up here for quick respawns and defense. I included roof bunkers in this layer to separate your most valuable loot, especially to make offline raids more expensive. I also added some hidden loot lockers, also for offline raid protection. Here we have a retake peak for the shooting floor. We got some nice firing gates from here to get rid of people outside or holding the breach. There are beds for respawns and peaks into the China wall and compound. These roof peaks allow you to shoot players below while being covered, so you don't get shot from raid bases or people outside. The ramp peaks into the open core are quite basic but highly effective. The roof got retake peaks as well, in case you're getting top-downed. On top we have some sneaky ramp peaks, providing excellent angles in all directions. We have this little mountain roof over here to shoot players far behind. There are two vending machine bunkers where you can stash some more loot and increase raid costs even more. You open them by placing a roof like this. And now let's dive into the tutorial. We start building the starter base, which is a 1x3 this time. Now we build the multi-TC. You go out 5 squares and end with a triangle. Then you go back with triangles. Now you go out 2 squares and end with a triangle. Now we finish the multi-TC footprint. Now we build the external TC. Go out 5 squares, and that's your gatehouse. You have to build a wall on the left and right to build the bunker. Now you have to build the freehand foundation. You place it right if the wall is on 77% stability and the gap isn't too big. You can close the gap by placing this frame. Now we are building the early bunkers on both sides. Place a frame inside the bunker so the gap is gone. Make sure you have a gap here. That's very important. Now we are building the open core. You have to place a half wall with a low wall. You have to build the boxes now. You have to place the wall on the left. Now we are building the inner peak bunkers. You can't place a frame here. You can't place a frame right here as well. Now we are building the white gap footprint with the external TCs. Next step is building the China Wall footprint. Now we are building the China Wall. We're building the door for the funnel wall here. On the right, we place it like this. Make sure to place the battery first, before you build the roof. Now we are building the frames. Now we can close the inner peaks. Next step is building the hidden locker. Don't forget to lock it. Now we are building the shooting floor. Now we are building the roof. Thank you. Now we are building the furnace funnel wall. We have to place the wooden compound first. Build the walls in the middle of the windows. Now I'll show you windmill and turret placement. We built 4 turrets in the compound, 2 turrets on the roof, 2 turrets in the open core peaks, and 4 turrets in the mini China wall.